Daily Morning Prayer, Monday, September 2nd, 2024. I was glad when they said unto me, "We will go into the house of the Lord." Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent. According to your promises, declare to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and show yourselves. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. I will give thanks unto you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will speak of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in you. Indeed, my songs will I sing of your name, O Most High. When my enemies are driven back, they shall fall and perish at your presence. For you have maintained my right and my cause. You sit on your throne, judging right. You have rebuked the nations and destroyed the ungodly. You have blotted out their name forever and ever. As for the enemy, their destruction has come. They are in perpetual ruin, like the cities which you have destroyed. Their memory has perished with them. But the Lord sits enthroned forever. He has prepared a seat for judgment. For he shall judge the world in righteousness and minister true judgment to the peoples. The Lord will be a defense for the oppressed, even a refuge in the time of trouble. And those who know your name will put their trust in you, for you, Lord, have never failed those who seek you. O praise the Lord who dwells in Zion. Tell the peoples what things he has done. For when he takes vengeance for blood, he remembers them and forgets not the cry of the poor. Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider the trouble I suffer from those who hate me. O you who lift me up from the gates of death, that I may tell of all your praises within the gates of the daughter of Zion, I will rejoice in your salvation. The nations have sunk down in the pit, that they may, in the same net which they hid secretly as your foot caught. The Lord is known to execute judgment, that the ungodly are trapped in the works of their own hands. The wicked shall return to the grave, even all the peoples that forget God. For the poor shall not always be forgotten. The patient hope of the meek shall not perish forever. Rise up, O Lord, and let them not have the upper hand. Let the nations be judged in your sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be merely human. Why you stand? Why do you stand so far off, O Lord, and hide your face in the time of need and trouble? The ungodly in his cry persecutes the poor. Let him be taken in the crafty schemes that he has imagined. For the ungodly has boasted of his own heart's desire to covetous holds the Lord in contempt and blasphemes his name. The ungodly is so proud that he cares not for God, neither is God in any of his thoughts. His ways are always grievous. Your judgments are far above, out of his sight, and therefore he defies all his enemies. For he has said in his heart, I shall never be cast down. No harm shall happen to me. His mouth is full of cursing and deceit. Under his tongue are ungodliness and vanity. He sits lurking in the thievish corners of the streets, and in his hiding places he murders the innocent. His eyes are set against the poor, for he lies waiting secretly, even as a lion lurks in his den, that he may ravish the poor. He ravishes the poor when he gets him into his net. The innocent is crushed and humbled before him, and the weak cannot stand against his might. He has said in his heart, God has forgotten. He hides away his face, and he will never see it. Arise, O Lord God, and lift up your hand. Forget not the poor. Why should the wicked blaspheme God? Well, he says in his heart, you, O God, do not care. Surely you have seen it, for you behold ungodliness and wrong, that you may take the matter into your hand. The poor commits himself unto you, for you are the helper of the fatherless. Break the power of the ungodly and malicious. Search out his ungodliness until you have brought it all to light. The Lord is king forever and ever, and the nations have perished out of the land. O Lord, you have heard the desire of the poor. You prepare their heart, and you, and your ear hearkens to it. To help the fatherless and poor with justice, that the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. To help the fatherless and poor with justice, that the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. In the Lord I put my trust. How then can you say to my soul, flee as a bird unto the hill? For behold, the ungodly bend their bow and make ready their arrow upon the string, that they may secretly shoot at those who are true of heart. For the foundations will be cast down, and what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes consider the poor, and his eyelids try the children of men. The Lord tests the righteous, but the ungodly and those who delight in wickedness his soul abhors. Upon the ungodly he shall rain snares, fire, and brimstone, storm, and tempest. This shall be their portion to drink, for the righteous Lord loves righteousness. The upright shall behold his face. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the second book of Samuel, beginning with the 20th chapter, the first verse. Now a worthless man happened to be there, whose name was Sheba, the son of Bichri, a Benjaminite. And he blew the trumpet and said, we have no share in David, nor do we have an inheritance in the son of Jesse. Every man to his tents, Israel. So all the men of Israel withdrew from following David and followed Sheba, the son of Bichri. But the men of Judah remained loyal to their king from the Jordan even to Jerusalem. Then David came to his house in Jerusalem, and the king took the 10 women, the concubines whom he had left behind to take care of the house, and put them in custody and provided them with food, but did not have relations with them. So they were locked up until the day of their death, living as widows. Now the king said to Amasa, summon the men of Judah for me within 3 days and be present here yourself. So Amasa went to summon the men of Judah, but he was delayed longer than the set time which he had designated for him. And David said to Abishai, now Sheba, the son of Bichri, will do us more harm than Absalom. Take your Lord's servants and pursue them, so that he does not find for himself fortified cities and escape from our sight. So Joab's men went out after him, along with the Chithrites and the Pelethites and all the warriors, and they left Jerusalem to pursue Sheba, the son of Bichri. When they were at the large stone which is in Gibeon, Amasa came to meet them. Now Joab was dressed in his military attire, and over it he had a belt with a sword in its sheath strapped on at his waist. And as he went forward, it fell out. And Joab said to Amasa, "Is it going well for you, my brother?" And Joab took hold of Amasa by the beard with his right hand to kiss him. But Amasa was not on guard against the sword which was in Joab's hand, so he struck him in the belly with it and spilled out his intestines on the ground and did not strike him again, and he died. Then Joab and his brother Abishai pursued Sheba, the son of Bichri. Now one of Joab's young men stood by him and said, "Whoever favors Joab and whoever is for David, follow Joab." But Amasa was wallowing in his own blood in the middle of the road, and when the man saw that all the people stood still, he removed Amasa from the road to the field and threw a garment over him. When he saw that everyone who came by him stood still, as soon as he was removed from the road, all the men went on after Joab to pursue Sheba, the son of Bichri. Now he went on through all the tribes of Israel to Abel, that is, Beth Ma'aka, and all the Bithrites, and they assembled and went after him as well. And they came and besieged him in Abel Beth Ma'aka, and they built up an assault ramp against the city, and it stood against the outer rampart. And all the people who were with Joab were wreaking destruction in order to topple the wall. When a wise woman called out from the city, "Listen, listen, please tell Joab, come here that I may speak with you." So he approached her, and the woman said, "Are you Joab?" And he answered, "I am." Then she said to him, "Listen to the words of your slave." And he said, "I am listening." Then she spoke, saying, "In the past they used to say, they will undoubtedly ask advice at Abel, and that is how they ended a dispute. I am one of those who are ready for peace and faithful in Israel. You are trying to destroy a city, even a mother in Israel. Why would you swallow up the inheritance of the Lord?" Joab replied, far be it from me that I would consume or destroy. Such is not the case, but a man from the hill country of Ephraim, Sheba, the son of Bichri by name, has raised his hand against King David. Only turn him over, and I will depart from the city." And the woman said to Joab, "Behold, his head will be thrown to you over the wall." Then the woman wisely came to all the people, and they cut off the head of Sheba, the son of Bichri, and threw it to Joab. So he blew the trumpet, and they were dispersed from the city, each to his tent. Joab also returned to the king at Jerusalem. Now Joab was in command of the entire army of Israel, and Benaniah, the son of Jehoiada, was over the Chethrites and the Pelethites, and Adoram was over the forced labor, and Jehoshaphat, the son of Elihud, was the secretary, and Sheva, the scribe, and Zadok and Abiathar were priests. Ithra, the Jairite, also was a priest to David. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore, you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day, you shall say, "Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion. Ring out your joy. The great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen." A reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Ephesians, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. "And you were dead in your offenses and sins, in which you previously walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, of the spirit that is now working in the sons of disobedience. Among them we too all previously lived in the lusts of our flesh, indulging the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, just as the rest. But God, being rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our wrongdoings, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the boundless riches of his grace and kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand, so that we would walk in them." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do your homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Lord, be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. O Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow after us, that we may continually be given to good works through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep our law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, sent down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving spirit of your grace, shower them with the continual dew of your blessing, and ignite in them a zealous love of your gospel, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and your promise, through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.